I started loving Excel when I saw how much you could do with functions and formulas. Once you dive in, there are so many ways you can crunch your numbers. I'm going to show you how to get started with functions, and I'm going to show you some special functions that everyone needs to know. I have this simple spreadsheet showing the battery ranges of all the current plug-in hybrid vehicles. As you can see, there's a lot of difference in the mileage between all of these cars, and I want to calculate the average. So here's how you start a formula. You go to the cell where you want the formula to be, and then you start typing up here. Every formula starts with an equal sign. That's the first step. And then I can just start typing in average here. And as you can see, there are a list of functions that show up. Here's average, and I can either keep typing it myself or I can double-click it to bring it in. Now, when I started typing that, you see there are these other functions that showed up. If you're wondering what those are, all you have to do is click the name and you'll get a brief definition. Another way to enter a function is through the formulas menu. You just click formulas at the top, and at the far left you see a button called Insert Function. You click that and a dialog box comes up where you can start typing in the function you want. So I want average, I'm going to type that in and hit go, and there it is. And now that will show up in the cell that I selected, and it's also already guessed the number range I want. So I'm going to hit that there just to show you that the average works. But then I'm going to show you other ways you can find a function, and this is my favorite. It's the next button over, it's called AutoSum, and you click that, and it comes up with a list of the most common formulas that everyone uses all the time. So look, here's average right here. I click it, and not only does it put the average formula in the cell, but it goes up and auto-selects what it thinks I want to average. So it's all there for me, and it's done. But there are more ways. You also have the next button over, recently used. It remembers the formulas that you used most recently, and say you want to use it again, it's right there. Here's a good old average. It's pre-selected my range. I'm done. Finally, you can click one of these function subcategories like financial or logical to narrow down what you're searching for. Now that you have your function, you have to tell Excel what numbers you want to use with it, and you do that in parentheses after the function. So you can enter the numbers manually if you want to. For instance, I can just type in B2, then put a comma, then B3 and a comma, B4 and a comma. I hit enter, and it'll average those three numbers. But entering numbers manually is super tedious, right? So there are other ways to do it. I know that I want all the numbers, so I can actually put in the first cell on the top, then put a colon, and then put in the last cell on the bottom, which is B12, hit enter, and it automatically averages everything in between those two cells. An even easier way to do it is to highlight the cell range with my cursor, just like that. Grab them all, hit enter, and there's your average again. But say that I want to average only the European cars on this list. I can select separate cells like this. I just select my first one. Then I hit the control button and hold it down. And I click the next one. Then I go down to the next one. And the next one. And this one. And as you can see in the formula entry bar on the top, each of these cells has its own color, so you can see which one it is in the formula bar. I've got them all, so I'm going to hit enter, and now it's averaged only those cars. Once you're comfortable with functions and formulas, you'll want to learn a few that will save you tons of time and heartache. This one is a classic. You have two cells that have the first name and the last name of something, and you need to put those names together into one cell. There's a function that will do this for you, and it's called concatenate. So here we have a spreadsheet showing four of my favorite apple desserts, but apple is separated from pie and strudel and so on, so I'm going to use concatenate to put them together. As you see, I've already done it for apple pie, and now I'm going to do it for apple strudel. I start with my equals sign, and then I take a deep breath and I type concatenate, and thank God the autofill saves me. I don't need to type all of that. Now, what I do is I select the two cells I want to put together, and that would be a 5. And here's the tricky part, you need to watch. I want a space between apple and strudel, so I actually have to tell Excel I want to put a space in. So I put quotation marks with a space in the middle, then another comma, and then the cell with strudel in it, which is B5. That's the end of my formula, and look at that, apple strudel showed up. Now that was a really tedious formula to enter, but luckily you can just copy it down to the other ones. So I'm going to hit Control C for copy, or any of the other ways you can copy a cell, and then select the next two cells where I want the formula, hit Control V or paste, and the formula pastes down. It sees the cells next to it and it does it all for me. Say you've just concatenated some cells, but there's weird spaces left over because of some formatting thing. There's a function to help you with that, and it's called trim. So here we are again with my apple desserts. And for apple pie, you can see I've already written the formula, and it's very simple. All you do is you type the equals sign and the word trim, parentheses, and then you just tell it which cell you want to get all those spaces out of. And that's A4. That's it. That's all you do. And as I did before, I'm going to copy this formula down to fix the other ones. Notice that it can remove extra spaces, but if you have words stuck together, it can't pull them apart. That's how easy it is to get started with Excel functions and formulas. Just start playing around, and don't worry. If something goes wrong, you can always hit the undo button. If you have any questions, just email us at answer@pcworld.com.